And I'm very happy about that one. Alright, so let's look at the puzzles here. So this is Rook Tactics 4 made in 1. So let's see what's going on here. Let's see which rooks can check. This rook can't check the king. This one could. I think it's just gonna go. I think it's gonna go to here to check the king in the past. And the other rook's gonna go here to cover it probably. Also, is it just me or is the sound a little quiet? Maybe that's just me. But yeah, this should be checkmate. Because the rook's checking the king all the way back. Alright. That was the first one. Let's go over through Bishop Tactics 1. What's up, Eklo? How you doing? Okay, so all of the bishop tactics are actually new, because there weren't any before. I didn't even notice, but that makes a lot of sense. So there's bishop tactics now, pawn tactics. Wait, there was pawn tactics before, right? I thought there was pawn tactics before, but maybe not. Maybe I'm remembering it wrong. And then there's unicorn tactics, dragon tactics. Wow. New opening traps. Alright. So let's start with the bishop tactics then. All the way up here. And quickly breeze over them, I hope. Alright, bishop tactics 1, mech in 1. Okay, so it's probably not gonna be. Wait, is it just here? Or like, is it just any of these squares? Because the bishop, the new bishop down here. No, it's not that simple. Could be a king. Oh, okay, it's just here, and then the bishop should be checking the king. One back to right here. Okay, I'm noticing I'm a little bit rusty because I haven't played in a while. They got updated. Alright, that makes sense as well. Maybe some puzzles got moved on, but yeah, this should be checkmate because the bishop should check the king. Should check the king back here next move. Alright, and that seems to be the case. Okay, let's continue. Go to next one. Mate in 1, okay, I mean this is just right here, the bishop's gonna be on the move right here, and gonna check like this on the board, one back to here, pretty, a classic one. I feel like this should be the first one maybe, when it comes to the bishop checkmates, because I feel like this one's actually easier than the first one. That's just me though. Alright, third one. Okay, same concept here, just playing black this time, and this time the bishops would already check him, but we just need to cover him by moving over the king here, and now the bishop's checking the king again. One move back, which is kind of the same concept. Again, I'm kind of wondering why this is the first one. Maybe to make it a little bit more challenging, makes sense as well. Alright. This one maybe a little bit more complex. Let's see. What's going on here? The bishop is not checking the king immediately, but probably could check the king all the way back here. If we go here, let's quickly calculate. Bishop's gonna be on the board here, going one back, two back, three back. No, so it's actually not a check because it only goes to square up here. So this is not a check actually. So let's see what is a check. So if it's four squares up from here, then this should be a check, right? Because now the bishop's gonna be on this square and it's gonna be one back, two back, three back, and it should check the king in the starting position. But it doesn't because I was one off. Okay. That's a little embarrassing. Okay, but let's check again. So this one was one off. So that's no good. So that's no good. It could be here, but I don't think so. No, is it just? Let's look at this for a moment. I'm pretty sure it's not here, right? Maybe it is. Maybe it checks the king here actually. Or maybe I'm insane. No, it actually makes perfect sense. Why would it check him here, but not here? No, okay, so it actually is here. Right? One back, two back. No, it's actually not. Okay. maybe it is a time travel move then. Unless it's here? Wait, this one could be it, because it's gonna be one back, two back. No, it's also not... No, wait, it is, right? Let's quickly check. Next move, the bishop's gonna be one back, two back. No, this is also not a check. Okay, so then it probably has to be time to move. Here, maybe? No, okay, it's here. Okay, it's this one. It's this one. Because now the bishop's gonna check the king up here. Okay, that's the one. Okay, that's actually pretty cool that none of the... It really looks like the bishop could check the king in the past on one of these squares here. But it's actually a nice shuffle for the king, so this is the only one that's gonna mate, because now the king's stuck up here and the bishop's gonna check him here. Alright, and that is the case. Okay, so at least not getting stuck on the mate in ones here. Which is... a relief, if nothing else. Alright, let's check back. Bishop tactics. 5. Mate in 1. Okay, so we are in check here. We are in check on this spot, so... There's something to be dealt about this. Let's see if the... If this bishop is maybe gonna check the king back here. Because if we're gonna make a move, we're gonna be on this spot, and then from here the bishop would go 1 back... 2 back, 3 back. Okay, but there's no board here, so that's not a check. What else can we do? We can't take the knight like this because the king's in check. We could. Okay, wait. So white already branched. So that's important to know. So there's maybe there's a couple of solutions here. We can't take. So I think let's check from this position first. We could do this and then capture the knight maybe. Okay, but now the king also got duplicated, so that's no good. So that's not an option. We could, if we take the knight here, maybe we're gonna be on this spot and then we're gonna go one up. No, wait, one up, two up. So I think this should be a check actually, because now the bishop is checking the king up here. And I think this should be checkmate because the bishop's not blocked on the square up here, so this should be checkmate, right? Oh, but it's covered by the knight. Okay, that's pretty cool. Man, these are a lot tougher than the first ones, I feel like. Maybe it's because this the first time I actually understand how to play the game before trying out the new puzzles. Okay, so we did find a check, but we did not find a checkmate because the knight was still protecting the knight. Down here would make sense. So if we don't take the pawn, what else is there? What if we just do this? Yeah, okay, it's just without taking the pawn. Okay, I get it. Because now the bishop's checking, but it's still black to move. And no matter where white goes here, the bishop would be able to take the king up here. So I think it was a mistake to do this move first, because also now the knight can't take the bishop now because it's black to move on this board. Okay, so it is the same check, but it's not the extra move here was a mistake here, and the bishop's still checking the king up here, going through the empty square on this board. Alright, so let's still allow it. Okay, pawn tactics. Alright, this is a classic smothered pawn mate. Wait, is it checkmate though? Yeah, it is. Okay, because there's no time travel move for black. Alright, fair enough. Just a normal 2D checkmate here by the pawn. nothing really too much going on here. So let's just go to the next one. Okay, this one's a little bit more interesting. What are we looking at here? I think we're looking at the king fork like this, because now only one of the kings could jump. Actually, fun thing to note here. So I assume this is the solution. Yeah. Actually, fun thing to note here. If it was black to move, he could maybe still get out of this actually by going. No, he actually can't, because there's two kings and he can only save one of them. No matter which one he takes, the other one's gonna get wrecked. But that's kind of a nice... I like this puzzle because it highlights just the the interdimensional moves for the pawn here in a very easy to grasp way. So that's a good one. I'm always so happy when I see that the new content is just adding on to the already existing ones and tutorializing the game even better. I'm a little surprised it's so many one movers. I was kind of expecting maybe some more two movers, but then again, there's already been some mistakes on these ones as well. Okay, so let's see. We're playing as white here, and we only have one board to move. And we're down the branch, so one thing to keep in mind here is that the king can capture as well if he wants to. So let's look at this for a moment. It is probably this, right? It's probably just moving the pawn up here, and it should check the king on this spot here because it's the one over and on the same square. So I think this should be checkmate, and the kings can't take this because it's covered by the bishop. And then there's an extra bishop here to confuse you. But yeah, this should be checkmate because now the pawn is checkmating the king on exactly this square and only this square, and hitting it like that. Alright. Very nice. I like the new pawn tactics. I'm kind of surprised, like, but weren't there pawn tactics before in the game, or am I just remembering it wrong? I could have sworn there were pawn tactics before as well. I don't know. What's up, Lizard Tim? I'm here. Alright. So, 7 more to go. I actually did one of them before I started off the game because I couldn't wait. I did the tricky checkmates, but I'm still gonna show it. The other ones I haven't seen yet. Okay. Let's go king tactics. Mate in one. So the kings can't move like that because they would put themselves in check. So it has to be a time jump, I'm pretty sure. Because all of the other moves are probably gonna be illegal unless there's one. So let's look at this. This one's actually a little tricky, I feel like, to really remember. So it has to be a square where the king can hit one of black kings, but it's not black to move. I actually don't see it immediately here. So let's think about it for a moment. Let's just look at the moves here. It can't be. Any of those checking moves because the king could hit it. It might be related. Putting one of them. Wait, it's still mate in one, right? No, it's mate in one, so there's no Zugzwang. It has to be mate immediately. Alright, let's figure this out. So I did expect this to be a time travel move, but any of these two squares don't actually check black because the timeline's gonna be down here. So any timeline gonna be down here would have to check the king on this square right here. Okay, so it's probably this then, right? Okay, but the king's already hitting this. Okay, that's interesting. That's interesting. So we'd have to. Maybe it has to do with moving one of the kings and then time traveling to that board. Like, what if white goes here and then also here? No, then the king is still covering the square. Okay, interesting. So maybe it can't be the top board because the pawn's covering the square. So it has to be on the bottom board, I'm pretty sure. Oh, it's just this because now white is keeping his move on this board, so there's no king capture. And now the king is hitting this king instead, and the top king can't interfere. So I think this should be checkmate. Alright, that's it. That took me a while, though. Really, really, really nice puzzle. always adding on to the concept of keeping your move on the board where you want to checkmate on. Very, very, very cool one. Like this one a lot. Right. Oh, that wasn't... okay, the other two were already in the game. So that makes sense. I was kind of surprised that the first King Tactics is so such a tough one, but it's actually the third one, but the only new one. Okay, let's go. Unicorn Tactics. Oh, God. This is where it gets interesting. Alright, unicorns, triagonals. We know how to do that. Okay, so I think on this one you can kind of do any king move and it should be checkmate, right? Because this move, the unicorn is hitting this square, and next move from the board, it's going to be black to move, then white to move, and from this board, the unicorn should go to this square and to this square and check the king. So I think any king move is going to be checkmate. Yeah, and because now the unicorn is hitting the king on the triagonal, and I think any king move works here. Okay, very, very cool. Alright, that wasn't too bad. Let's do the second one. Okay, this looks a little more complex. Okay, so second thing to note: where does the unicorn go? So here would be my first idea. Okay, now it's getting tricky, because now I have to remember which one of the queen moves is the triagonal move. I think like this is the first square I'm looking at, and I'm looking at the king up here as the most vulnerable one. Let's double check though. It could also be here actually. Okay, wait. It's probably here, right? Then it should go one up, two up. No, but it can't be. It can't be because the pawn is actually blocking this. Okay, that's actually interesting. Like, check this out. Like this would normally be a check, I believe, because the unicorn could go one over, two over to here, but it's actually blocked by the pawn. So this one actually doesn't work. So we need to find something better then, because the pawn already moved here. That's kind of cool. That's the first thing I would look at, and it's this one is blocked. So what else is there? I still believe it should be a time to remove from the unicorn. Wait, no, it's probably just here then, right? Yeah, okay, it's probably just here then, and then it should go one back to this square, and then two back to this square. Should be the check, right? Because it's three dimensions. Okay, it is. Yeah, because now the unicorn is hitting the king in the past. And the time travel move doesn't work, actually, because the, Just now I quickly show it. Now the pawn is blocking the check up here. That's pretty cool though. That's pretty cool. Alright, Dragon Tactics. This is where it gets worse. Yeah, the other one. Yeah, we can actually quickly check if the other square also works. Because I wasn't too sure if this one works. No, it doesn't. It doesn't. Okay, because if it was a bishop, it would checkmate the king up here. But because it's a unicorn, it doesn't work. Okay, let's go. Dragon Tactics. Alright, so. The dragon. moves in the quadragonals. So this is probably going to be a little bit tougher to calculate in your head. But let's see. Okay, so it has to be. I was just wondering why can't black just make a queen here and checkmate the king on and checkmate the king here. Probably also could, but I think this is probably the checkmating move, because then it's black to move, white to move on this board, and then black to move on this board, and the dragon should checkmate the king right here, right? Because it goes on one dimension, two dimension, and then two on the board as well. So I think this is going to be checkmate. Because now the dragon should checkmate the king here. Alright, and that is indeed the case. I just quickly want to check if what happens if black just makes a queen here and okay, no, it can't be mate in one because the present is not caught up. That's why this is not. This would checkmate the king later, but for the time being it's not good enough. Also I think white can probably take the queen even from back here. Alright. So I think this is the only move then. Alright. Very cool. not too bad. Maybe as soon as there's more, it's gonna be tough. Probably tough to set up dragon tactics even. Okay, let's go. Opening traps 2, mate in 1. Okay, so there it's between the 1 and 3. So let's check this one out. Okay, so let's look at the game and judge the game. Okay, so it's a Scandinavian. White takes, bishop out, okay, and then the knight out, and the queen. Oh, it's the queen sacrifice. Alright, that's pretty cool. Queen sacrifice, knight recaptures, and now black's gonna checkmate on the open file here, where white wouldn't opened up his king file. Alright, that's a pretty cool one. Classic one. Alright, we got two more here. Opening traps 5, wow. What's up, Snickerdoodle? Yeah, dude, I'm really enjoying the new puzzles. Actually, some of them took me a while. In particular, I think one of the bishop ones took me a while, and the king tactics. The last king tactics is actually kind of tricky. Opening traps, I think, not so much. Wait, okay, but this isn't standard. This isn't standard at all. This is, well, what's this mode called again? It's a no bishops mode, right? Simple no bishops. Alright, but let's see. Okay, so we're in check. We're up the branch. So it's probably time to remove from this spot, right? Yeah, okay, it's just to here. Because we actually checkmated ourselves here, or like softmated it, I guess, because the queen's hitting the king on all the timelines. So the only legal move we have is time traveling from this board. Actually, this is kind of interesting. Is the only legal move white has here is a checkmate? I think this actually might be. Is this CTP trolling us? I think the only legal move white has is this, right? That is pretty amazing. Because white can't make a move here, because the queen's checking the king. So I think the only legal move white has is this actually. Oh, that is. Oh man, he must have been having a laugh at this. That is so funny. No, white cannot Jurassic Rook here because wait, he can actually. Okay, no, but not far enough because this doesn't shift back the present. So to complete the turn here for white, they still need to make a move here, and that's not possible because the queen's covered by the knight, and the rook doesn't go back far enough. But yeah, that's a good eye that the rook actually moved out of the way here. But man, that is really really funny that white's only legal move is to give the checkmate here. that is so funny. Oh man, that is amazing. Yeah, it also does teach to how to handle a softmate. You're very correct. Yeah, that's actually a really good point. It actually teaches a lot of different concepts here. Because like the first thing people are gonna probably try is to move out of the checkmate here, but they're quickly gonna see that that's not the case, and then they're gonna maybe start making other moves. But quickly seeing that this mate's always a problem, and then the only legal move is to time travel and give the checkmate one move earlier. That's really nice. I really like this one. Very cool. Alright, so I quickly also want to show this one. I think this one's also new. I couldn't hold myself back to at least try one of the new puzzles, and I wanted to do the toughest one. But yeah, this one looks a little bit like the one earlier. Let me just quickly show it. It looks pretty similar to not this one, but this one actually. Where there's one pawn here and you have to give the checkmate on the other one. And the solution here was to give the checkmate like this, putting black in Zugzwang, because he can't, he would have to do this, but now the bishop's hitting it, and he has to advance the spot. So that's kind of why, what this reminded me of, when it had the pawn here. And yeah, like I said, I already did the solution on this one. To get you over the thought process I had, was the first thing I tried, of course, was, seeing if I can give a check here, but it turns out there's always it's always one off, and there's no way to give a check otherwise, or maybe trying to cut black off, but it all doesn't work. And then the only thing that's left to try is making a move on one board and then time traveling to the other. And I actually did, like, the first attempt I had was this, where I moved the pawn up and then moved the queen to here. That was my first attempt that I thought might be made, but here black can just move out away, and the quadrangular checkmate would only occur next move. Like if the queen was here, it could go to this square and to this square and checkmate the king here. So, and the actual solution is to get the queen over here and then time travel from the bottom board, when now the bottom queen is protecting the queen up here for the checkmate. But yeah, that's a really cool one. Really, really nice one. Hops bang. Yeah, this one was super cool. And really, after I did this one, I thought to myself, no, you can't do this in your off time. You have to show them on stream. And we still got one left. And this one I haven't seen at all. So let's see if I can figure this one out. Because the first advanced branching actually took me a long time. This one actually took me a long time when I saw it for the first time. Which was really cool, but I'm not gonna spoil all the puzzles. You can see them yourself. Okay, but we're still gonna do this one. Advanced branching mate in one. Alright, so what do you say to advanced branching? So first thing to note here is we can time travel twice, and white cannot. So Let's see. So the present is back here. So this here is no good. Taking here is no good. It would lead to a checkmate on one of the kings, but the present is not here but back here. So the checkmate has to occur right here. So I'm kind of wondering. So the first juicy move I see is going here. And this would be a checkmate pretty soon. But let's try and figure this out. I think it's going to be tough to do this one in my head. So I might eventually put some moves on the board anyway, but for the time being, let's just see what we can try and figure out here. Wait, actually, what's the problem with going here? It would checkmate the king on the board up here if it's white to move. Okay, but black can still move out of the way. So what if? I have some candidate moves here. First candidate move is. Oh wait! I actually think. What if black takes here, and then takes the bishop to time travel on the new bottom board here. Wait. So we take this bishop. Take the rook here, it puts white in check. Now, no wait, it's white to move. Okay, that's okay, I completely forgot. You can't do both. You can't do two moves on robot, of course. Of course. So what else is there? Let's try and figure out some moves here. So these two are no good, that I'm pretty sure about. This would be a candidate move if this was a normal game, but I think it's too slow for checkmate in one. Right? Because let me just see. So white can just take back here, right? Yeah, white can just take back. So that's no good. Unless, okay, now I get it. Okay, so it is this move, and then also. No, wait, no. I was thinking the knights could protect themselves. So it has to be two checks. It has to be two checks. So where's the second one? This would be a candidate move, but I think they can still take back unless we cover it somehow. Can we cover this? It would be nice if you could cover it somehow, but I don't see it immediately. So let's see. Maybe it's because the bishop's protecting. What squares is this bishop protecting? Up here. Only it's protecting this square up here, but I think that's not good enough. This is a candidate move. This is a candidate move. Those are more or less the only two I have. If you do this, the knight is checking the king up here, but they can still go. That's not good enough. Like if black takes here. Okay, wait, actually check. Okay. That's good information. That if we branch twice, the bishops are actually checking. So there actually is no branch twice then, right? Interesting. So let's go back to the bishop move then. Let's go back to the bishop move. Unless it's this. But this doesn't really seem right, right? What goes here? No, that's not good. I think it's this. I think it's this. But we need to cover the bishop somehow. Because right now white can just recapture. We would need some sort of second threat. We need a second threat, or cover the bishop somehow. Like, what if we do the second branch? It doesn't cover the bishop is a problem. Is it a king jump actually? It could be. No, it can't be. It's too big brain. So it could be here. Oh, knight move. Like at least those are the checks I'm seeing. I think this is too slow, right? This is too slow because now the king can still move out of the way. Okay, wait. No. Okay. I think I got it. If you go here. We need to make it so the king can't go to this square. I think if you control this square right here, this should be checkmate. Because this square is already cut off, and the king still needs to move out of the way. How do we achieve that though? Like here would be normal, right? If black goes here. No, that's no good. That's no good. Maybe I also need to do the second move. Maybe I need to do the other move first. Because I was thinking this square right here cuts off. No, it actually doesn't. I'm fairly confident that this is probably the checkmate move and not the bishop move. Because this one checks immediately. And now if. Wait, what am I talking about? They can also time travel. No, they can't, because these two are covered by the knight and the bishop. This one doesn't shift the present. And this one's covered. It could be one of those maybe, but okay. So if you can, so white can go here now. That's the problem. White can still go there. So how do we use the bishop to prevent that? It has to be a jump, right? The problem is, like every jump now puts them in check is the problem, right? Yeah, this is still a check from the bishop then. Okay, so that's always a check. So that's no good. Doesn't really want to move out of the way. Let's try again. Because this is not good enough. White can go here, and they can just move out of the way on the other boards. That's not good enough. Wait, unless it's... I mean, this would be... This would be good, but the problem is the presence not here. Because this also would be covered by the knight, actually. Going 1 over, 2 over, 2 over. So this actually would be protected. But why? Problem is the second branch is too cut off. There's no way there's interference from this. This would be the only sensible move I see. This would be the only sensible move I see to try and interfere. But it just doesn't seem right. So maybe it's not a knight move at all. Maybe it is a different move at all, after all. At least I didn't see it immediately. Okay, let's try something else though. Hey, what where else could black check white? Let's quickly try the bishop check again. Like this, and then the second branch. What would the second branch be? Like these two are never an option. Is it somehow possible to get the branch to back here? It would have to be a king move. This. No wait, actually that doesn't make sense. No, it can't be a jump to this board. Can't be. So how is the bishop then contributing to the checkmate actually? That's what I'm asking. Like what's the point of this whole board here? This one is a good one. This one's a good one. I'm struggling here for sure. I was really thinking it would be either the bishop move or the knight jump here, but maybe it's none of the two actually. Maybe it's none of the two actually. But this doesn't make sense. This doesn't make sense. Okay, let's just go over the moves then. If it's not the bishop, okay. Let's look at the bishop one again quickly. Not too much though. Like the bishop here would protect the bishop here, but the problem is, it's white to move on both. If it was black to move somehow, this would be good. Wait, I have another idea actually. No, I don't. I was thinking we could maybe branch 3 times, but we only have 2 moves, so that's not on the menu. So we can branch 2 times max. But the second one can't be to this board, because then it's in check. Oh, I'm so stupid. Why don't I just do this first, and then jump the knight? Shouldn't this be good? No, okay, it's same problem, okay. Still always gotta check. Always gotta check. Okay, so let's look at the bishop check again then. Because the only thing we need to do now is cover the bishop somehow. King jump here is not good enough. Because there's no knight to protect the bishop. Like, bishop here would technically protect it, but it's one too far back. I don't think it can be this. But I want to look at the knight jump one last time. I'm sorry. I want to look at it one last time because it's really only this square that's the problem. No, it's not. Wait, what? The, Wait, the king can't go here, right? Because the knight's covering the square. One up, two up, one up. So I think is this actually just checkmate? Did I just get in my own head? Because the knight's checking up here, but the king can't move out of the way, because this is covered and this is also covered by the knight. Maybe it's just that simple. Maybe I've been overthinking this the whole time. Because okay, let's see though. Well, what else could white do? White can't. Can white jump? No, it can't. He can't. White would have to jump to this board. And I don't think that's possible. This is also not possible. This one's covered by the knight. This one's covered by the bishop. So that's no good. There's no rook jumps. The knight's not hanging. The knight's not hanging because the bishop protecting this. Maybe this is just checkmate? No. Ah, okay, because the bishop can still jump. Very good. Oh, we actually lose. Wow. Even better. Alright. So it's not that simple. That's actually reassuring. Because I would have been surprised if it was this simple. Okay, so let's check again then. So the only thing white can do here is do this, but that's good enough. So that's pretty sad. Okay, so wait, so is it maybe it's a king jump then? Maybe it's a okay. So it's okay. I think I get it. You wanna branch once. You wanna branch once to this board, probably putting him in check, and then do the knight jump, and now the bishops can't reach the knight. I think that's the point. Because now there's the void here, so there's no board in between. And here white has to capture, and the knight's still not hanging. I think, no, but now the knight's too far to check the king. Yikes. Okay, no. Now the knight's checking the king here, okay. Dude, I was way overthinking this. This should be checkmate, right? Okay, that's good. I was making this more complicated than it actually had to be. Because I was looking at the legal moves for the king on this board, where you actually just branch once and then give the checkmate here. That is actually, wow. That should not have taken me this long. But I mean, it is advanced branching. That is very true. Very, very nice puzzle.